right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Jean-Marie Clouet. He is the corporate director for Agnico Eagle Mines. And Jean-Marie, great to see you. How are you?
Good afternoon, Steve. Thank you very much. I'm everything good on this end in Toronto, so I'm happy to be here with you.
Awesome. Good stuff. Well, I want to learn a little bit more about the company, one of the giants in the mining industry, of course. Maybe just for folks who may not know much about Agnico Eagle, tell me a little background on the company.
Sure. So Agnico Eagle has been in operation since 1957. It's a gold producer. Actually started as a silver cobalt producer in the cobalt region of Ontario, and then production came mostly after that in gold in the Abitibi region of Quebec. And it has grown fairly quickly from 2005 all the way to 2020, from a single producer of 200,000 ounces per year to what it is nowadays of 3.3 million ounces per year, putting us in the third as a third major producer for gold in the world.
Yeah, the company just released a bit of an update on what you were doing as far as projects are concerned, because you do have obviously a number of projects. And so I wanted to ask you about a few of them and get some updates. One of them is the Detour Project. Maybe remind everyone about that project and you're expanding, some expansion drilling is happening there right now.
Correct. So the Detour Mine actually is an interesting project. There was an initial operation there in the 90s, an underground operation. It was then restarted in the 2000s as an open pit. And this is like a major open pit. It's become the largest open pit in gold producer in Canada. We're just recently updated a technical study, which resulted in an increase in the mineral reserves for that operation of about 5.6 million ounces, bringing it to 20 million ounces. We've extended the mine life to like 10 years, bringing it to 2052. So we're increasing the throughput rate to 28 million tons per year by 2025. And we see opportunities to increase it further. And that's, we'll need to complete some studies to validate that, maybe bring it to 32 million tons per year. And we also see the recent drilling showing the mineralization extending to the west by about 2 kilometers. And that extension to the west seems to indicate also potential for a new underground component that would add again to the production that we're seeing currently. So with this new study, we improve the production profile over the next 20 years. And so we expect to be able to hopefully in the next iteration to show further improvements, maybe from the 800,000 ounces per year that we think can bring it to, maybe to 1 million ounces per year. That would be a long-term vision that we have, but still requires studies to get there.
Okay. You also talked about some of the other projects in there, Kirkland Lake, Hope Bay, Odyssey Underground. I mean, names that people know because of just their sheer size of them. Can you sort of give me a brief update on what's going on elsewhere within the company and those projects?
Sure. So Odyssey, it's another, like that's a large open pit again. Yeah. It was the largest open pit gold mine last year. Now it's Detour. It's another operation that was in operation since the 1950s. So like just showing that very often where mine has been mined, gold has been mined, like that's one of the best places to find further upside gold in the region. So the open pit will be coming to an end in the next few years, by 2026, 2027. But we've shown an extension underground, which is the Odyssey project. And based on the study and the construction that's ongoing, this will become the largest gold underground mine in Canada at about 19,000 tons per day. Again, this where the drilling is showing some interesting results on the extensions. We've shown some extension to the east of about 1.7 kilometers potential extension, and even to the west, maybe another 250 meters extension to the west. So it shows that although the project that we have currently is already relatively large and interesting with the mine life up to 2040, there is still potential to grow.
Yeah. How about Hope Bay?
So Hope Bay, it's a project that we acquired in last year, where we had operations when the time of the acquisition. Due to COVID and also the size of the operation, we ended up like stopping operations, paying care and maintenance, and really focusing on exploration. What we want is over the next 2 years really to show the potential. We know there's a lot of gold in the region, and what we think is needed is a lot of drilling really to go and prove a project that we think could be anywhere from 250 to 350,000 ounces per year, which is needed really when you're mining in the north. The results currently that we're seeing at Doris are really interesting. We've shown that there's further intersects, further extension at depth, also probably to the east and the west, with fairly significant grades and potential again to grow. So the plan there is really to drill over the next 2 years, carry on the studies and come up with a larger production plan probably towards 2024, 2025.
Jean-Marie, you're obviously very busy with a lot of the projects you're working on right now. Is the company always looking at potentially picking up other projects as well, or do you like where you're at now? How does that sort of fit into the scheme of how you move things forward?
Sure. So Agnico Eagle has been known to really as a mine builder and operator. And the way the company has been built is mostly through early stage investments in companies. So we're really a regional focus operator. We've got a strong base in the Abitibi. We have a strong base in Ontario, a strong base in Nunavut. We're in Finland and Australia. And what we do, like we have teams in each of these areas that really look and know all the projects and the juniors that are exploring in the area. And what we like to do is we like to do to hold investments to be able to learn the project, help the junior develop it. And then if we see the upside potential, really acquire and develop and build it ourselves. We think that that's a strategy that has worked, that has been very successful for the company. And we keep on doing that. We have a very strong technical team that looks at all the projects within the regions where we are. We intend to carry on this strategy. If we see an opportunity, we will acquire and build for the region,
build
operational center.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. Jean-Marie, thanks so much for the update. Appreciate it. I know the company's very busy and you are as well, so we appreciate your time.
Thank you very much.
All right, there's Jean-Marie Clouet. He's a corporate director for Agnico Eagle.